Casper the Firefly, he's the friendliest G10T, with his turbo hood and his GT wheels. Casper the friendly G10T.
Oh, just messed around with the Mark 1 a little bit today. Vacuumed out the back of it. You see anything in there? Just to get rid of some of the dirt that was on the floor. I got my tire guy Kevin coming, so I put the tires in the car waiting for him. Oh, it's a dirty girl. And to put a little bit of a clean on the engine. Just to make it look a little better. I lost all my hardware for the brakes, so I've got brake hardware coming on with a kit. Unfortunately, out of the U.S., because, you know, that's just about the only place this stuff is anymore. Excuse me. Oh, well. I hope to hear about the other body shell soon. And I can start tearing this apart. Once I know it's coming. No point tearing this apart if I haven't got another one to put it on. More to come. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. A beautiful day in this neighbor. It's a great day for tinkering. So I had the front brakes apart. I had to free a stuck piston and free a stuck slider. Lubricated those up. Piston seems to be working at this time. It's probably going to stick again, but you know, I've got new pads in there. The hardware is back in place, so I've got a nice firm pedal, and I found this on this side. I knew the brake pads had been messed with by the people before, but they didn't get this far, and I don't think the brake pad's supposed to be that bent. But, yeah, those were the pads that were in there. So, it's got brakes now. Great. So I get to the fuel tank, because they said they had to put a fuel pump in it. And I guess they did. But they didn't use this. They used this dinky little contraption. I mean, it's not even half the size of this. So I've got this to replace, and it's going in right now. Soon enough we'll know if that's the hesitation issue. Man, it's not pretty under here. Oh, this thing's in tough shape. But it's an 87 and it's on the road, so better than nothing. More to come. All right. It's now the evening of the 6th. I've had the fuel tank out and the old fuel pump has been replaced. I don't know if this is a metro pump or what, but it certainly isn't big enough to handle a turbo. So I got everything done underneath. Patched up some hack work by the previous owner when they put this mystery fuel pump in. How's that sound? Ooh, new tires. Gee, I wish there was a place I could just hang this thing. Yay, I can stop. Nice solid pedal again. Well, that was hard to find third. I really think this needs a set of shifter bushings. Door creaks quite a bit because the door is mostly the frame of the vehicle right now. There's an old Mustang. A little high in the back end. Still a little hesitating, but way better than the other pump. When I was driving this back on the highway from Edmonton, you couldn't floor it at all. It would overboost badly. I freed up the wastegate actuator and that problem seems to have gone away. The fuel tank on this thing is just filthy, and I wouldn't be surprised if the filter's already clogged up inside the tank. And that's why it's getting hesitating. But it runs. Yay. It drives. He gets these on Wednesday. Kevin's going to actually come here with his tire service van and service my tires. Here it goes, settles right down. Alrighty then. Can't wait to start playing with this. More to come.